Now let's bring in Lagos State Commissioner for Information and Strategy, Gbenga Omotosho, for more on this development. So we spoke earlier with an NSAS campaigner who highlighted the moral inaccuracy of what the Lagos State government has planned to do. According to him, he's saying that judgment hasn't been served yet for those who were allegedly killed and those who were injured during the 20th October incident. And that is why they think LCC shouldn't, you know, take back the toll gate. How do you respond to that?
Well, first let me just say that the two contending forces who are saying that they want to protest on Saturday, they don't have any need to say so, because the panel that is sitting on the incident of October 20 and NSAS brutality, SAS brutality, it has not made any pronouncement, any final decision on any matter concerning all of the things that people have put before it. So I do not see why people should go and protest. And if the panel has said that SEC should go back to the gate, what has happened is that an analogy that I gave earlier in the day, you are the landlord of a house, there's a fight in the house, the police come in and they arrest people. And the police said the house should be shut down. And the house was shut down. And then the police sending people to go and investigate. Experts, were cutlasses used, were knives used. And then the experts have investigated and have come back to the police to say that this is what we have found out that happened in the place. And then the police said, okay, we have looked at it, we have investigated, we are going to make a pronouncement on this matter. But landlord, go back to your house and assess the damage. And are you now telling me that the landlord cannot go there and assess the damage and look at all of the things that have been destroyed in his house and think of how to rebuild the house and think of how to bring back his workers, the gardeners, the chefs, the cooks, and all of that? No, I think justice for one is justice for all. We have to look at it. It's not. Justice should not be sectional.
What the panel is saying now is that they already have the forensic report and that there is no need to return to the toll gate to gather any further evidence. But when you hear the Commissioner of Police say no one should go out to protest, is that not a flagrant infringement on human rights clearly stated in the Constitution? Anyone has the right to conduct himself in a peaceful manner, protesting in whatever rights or for whatever reasons that he desires.
At that same press conference that the police commissioner spoke, the attorney general and commissioner for justice also spoke. He said, people have a right to protest. But there are two contending forces now. One is saying that we are going to protest, continue NSAS protest. Another is saying that we are going to defend Lagos. Looking back to what happened in October, towards the end of October, when we had that carnage, the kind of carnage we had never witnessed in Lagos before, quite unimaginable, just on a scale beyond belief. All of the iconic buildings that we grew up to know in Lagos being touched just like that. Nobody wants a repeat of that. So the Attorney General was clearly saying that, yeah, you have a right to protest, but where your right stops, that is where the rights of others begin. That people have a right to move around. You cannot say because you are protesting again, you are shutting down a major road like Lekki, and then all of the problems that people had at that time, people were going to the hospital, they couldn't get there, people died in their cars, and so many other things, and that you are going to have a repeat of that. Mm-hmm. So you say you have a right to protest, but other Lagosians, they have a right to their peace. So nobody is saying that people cannot protest, but if there are two contending forces arrayed against each other, you can foresee trouble. And nobody wants trouble in Lagos. All we are talking about is peace. We want peace.
What then is the role of the police? If there are two opposing, you know, people protesting, what would expect that the police should be there to ensure that it doesn't result into a free-for-all? Doesn't the state government have confidence that the security infrastructure has the capacity to maintain these opposing voices if that protest holds on Saturday?
If you can persuade people, this is a government that believes in persuasion. If you can persuade people not to go out and begin to protest, because the protest is likely, it has, there's the proclivity of some bad people to hijack protests, as we saw in October last year. So why is it that the government will allow that kind of thing to go on? And what the government is saying is that when security agencies, they are trained to do their job, they can do it, but we have a duty to persuade our people to say we don't want trouble in Lagos. And that's what the government is saying.
When you say persuade, what form of engagement happened now between the state government and all of the stakeholders who are interested in coming out to protest?
A lot. We have been talking to civil society organizations, those who are saying they want to protest and those who are saying they want to have a counter protest. We have been talking to traditional rulers. We have been appealing on radio and television and talking to parents and guardians to hold their words. We have been telling people that two wrongs don't make a right. Even if you feel aggrieved by what the panel has said, it is not time for you to go out to the street. People cannot say, if you don't have it my way, it has to be the highway. No, it is not done. We are in a modern society, and no modern society, especially like Lagos, with the economic potentialities and what Lagos represents to Africa and to Nigeria, with its 84 billion GDP, can allow the kind of carnage that we had in October last year to go on. So the government is persuading everybody and talking to everybody. A lot is going on underground to make sure that we remove this tension enveloping everywhere because of NSAS protests coming back again and telling people that we can no longer afford that kind of carnage again in Lagos.
Come Saturday, what are your expectations and what do you say to commuters along the Lekki axis?
My expectation is that Lagosians should not panic. They should carry on with their businesses without any fear that they may be attacked or that anybody may put them in any trouble whatsoever. Because, like I said, the security agencies, they know their jobs, they are going to do that. The government has done enough to persuade everybody to say that there is no need to go to the highway. I mean, you can't have everything your way. If you don't have it your way, it doesn't have to be the highway. You take it easy. All of us, we have a lot to gain in peace. So we are appealing to everybody. We are talking to traditional rulers. We are talking to our young people. We are asking them that instead of going to the streets again, see what you can do. Join us with everybody. If you have any grievances, go to the panel. If the panel has said something that you don't like, there is room for appeal.
Indeed. Lagos State Commissioner for Information and Strategy, Bingo Motosho, thank you for talking to us tonight.
Thank you so much.